Hello there. For me, this was emotional. Over the bank holiday weekend, I had the honour to be invited to attend events in the city of Sheffield in remembrance of those who made the ultimate sacrifice in 1982 to rightfully restore the Falkland Islands to those under our protection who lived there. Nothing I could ever say would ever measure up to the great sacrifices that were made by my fellow servicemen during the Falklands War of 1982. And nothing I could say would ever match the commitment of the people of the city of Sheffield to the ships that have, and will in the future, bear the name of that fair city. And my heartfelt thanks go to those that made the weekend, for many Sheffield survivors and their families, as well as the families of the fallen, both a remembrance and a release. In early 1982, HMS Sheffield was on deployment to sunnier climes. Here we are arriving at Diego Garcia in the Indian Ocean. But on completion, we docked in Gibraltar prior to a planned return to our home port of Portsmouth. But on the 2nd of April 1982, Argentine forces invaded the Falkland Islands. So when we left Gibraltar and headed westwards out of the Med, instead of turning starboard for home, we turned port with the beginnings of a task force and headed for the South Atlantic. We knew it was serious. And on the 1st of May, three Royal Navy ships, HMS Alacrity, HMS Arrow, and HMS Glamorgan, were all slightly damaged either by near misses from bombs or by cannon fire. But on the 4th of May at 14:07 Zulu time, which would be 7 minutes past three in the afternoon British summer time, the ship I was serving on, HMS Sheffield, was struck amidships on the starboard side by an Exocet missile fired from an Argentine Super 8 Ondard fighter. 20 of my shipmates were lost as a result, and the ship mortally damaged. She later sank under tow on the 10th of April. In all, we lost 7 vessels, and they are in order: HMS Sheffield, HMS Ardent, HMS Antelope, HMS Coventry, the Atlantic Conveyor, a roll-on, roll-off vessel taken up from trade for the war, RFA Sir Galahad, and a landing craft from the amphibious assault ship HMS Fearless, with the Royal British Legion saying, "Lasting 74 days, the conflict was the first military action since the Second World War that utilised all elements of the armed forces. 255 British personnel lost their lives defending the Falklands, of whom 86 were Royal Navy, 124 Army, 27 Royal Marines, 6 Merchant Navy, 4 Royal Fleet Auxiliary, and 8 Hong Kong sailors. 7 ships were also lost to enemy action and 9 aircraft shot down. And for balance, the Argentine forces lost 649 personnel, 323 of them on the Belgrano, which was sunk by torpedoes fired from the nuclear submarine HMS Conqueror. And yes, that was necessary, and it was the correct thing to do. The Argentine government had been given 7 days' notice that all combatant vessels would be targeted, wherever they were, and it does not matter which way the vessel was headed, because ships can turn round. The sinking of the Belgrano removed a significant threat to the task force and kept the Argentine Navy bottled up in port. If anyone is to blame, it is those that sent forces to invade the islands in the first place, not those sent to right the wrong. And 74 days is all it took, 2nd of April to the 14th of June. But the price was extremely heavy. And I was one of the lucky ones. Especially as 2 frigates came in close, right alongside the Sheffield, to assist our stricken destroyer. Here's what the Admiralty report said about the Sheffield. Much external assistance was provided. To port, Arrow did an excellent job of boundary cooling, supplying hoses and general support. Conditions for Yarmouth to starboard were less easy. Both ships' efforts were bedeviled by frequent spurious submarine and torpedo alarms. In the end, I, along with most of the crew, jumped from Sheffield onto the Arrow after our captain, Sam Salt, had given the order to abandon ship. This is what it looked like from the air. All that was 4 decades ago. 40 years. But for some of us, part of 1982 is like yesterday. But skip forward to today, and it is wonderful that the people of the city of Sheffield keep their affiliation with those vessels that bear the name HMS Sheffield, the Shiny Chef, as it's proudly known, so close to their hearts. And my heartfelt thanks go to all those that made my stay over the weekend so welcoming and comfortable. And to those who work behind the scenes to make all the associated events happen. The Farm Road Sports and Social Club. The Shiny Chef Pub, the most apt place for a Saturday night among those with an affiliation to the ships. And the next day I was invited to attend the Cutler's Hall, the HQ of the Company of Cutlers in Hallamshire. And opposite the hall stands Sheffield Cathedral, where flags from HMS Sheffield proudly hang. And after watching the parade march past, there was a service of remembrance in the cathedral, a service I will never forget. And then back to the Cutler's Hall for an excellent lunch with somewhere in the region of 300 attendees. Thank you, Sheffield. All rounded off with a fantastic performance by Cliff and the Shadows, a tribute band. But now I have to point out that for Argentina, the Falkland Islands are unfinished business. The Argentine ambassador to the UK, Javier Figueroa, called it an open wound. And he wants the UK to engage with Argentina over the sovereignty of the islands. He claims that the people of the UK are not interested in the island or the islanders, and that it is the number one foreign policy issue in Argentina. But as a Foreign Office spokesperson said, the United Kingdom has no doubt about its sovereignty over the Falkland Islands and surrounding maritime areas. But it is up to the Falkland Islanders to determine their own political status. In a 2013 referendum, the islanders voted overwhelmingly to remain a UK overseas territory. And for completeness, Argentina as a country never owned the Falkland Islands, and the islands being 400 or so miles away from the Argentine coast are way outside their exclusive economic zone. Argentina has no claim on the Falklands. They just think that because they are closest, their national pride should take precedence. No, it's up to the islanders themselves. And then there's the matter of the French-made anti-ship Exocet missiles used by Argentine forces to damage one ship and sink two others, the Sheffield and the Atlantic Conveyor. It is beginning to emerge that the French may have deliberately withheld secrets about the missiles that killed 42 of our sailors, with the Telegraph reporting that it has been told that French-made Exocet-guided missiles contained a kill switch that could have disarmed them, but that France denied such a device existed. The kill switch was allegedly designed to stop a foreign power getting hold of them and using one on a French target. And it seems we uncovered it when secretly inspecting one we had bought from the French earlier. Nice to see that even back then the French harboured less than friendly feelings about the UK, even though it claimed it was a fully committed NATO member, despite removing itself from the Integrated Military Command in 1966. The French should realise that trust is a hard commodity to come by and is so easily lost, especially if it caused the loss of our servicemen.